Hi, this is Tom Loschiavo, Chemistry Education Manager at PASCO Scientific, and I'm here today to talk about chemistry from a macroscopic and molecular perspective. Using PASCO's equipment and SPARKvue software, and Odyssey software for molecular visualizations. So let's take a look. I have the SPARKvue software set up in a table to record pressure and volume. Attached to that, I have the spark link. I have the chemistry sensor, which is going to be used to measure my pressure. And I have attached a syringe so I can change the volume. So it's a classic Boyle's law experiment. So on SparkVue, I have preset the volumes, and I'm going to record pressures at those volumes manually. I'm going to hit go, and I'm going to start recording. And I'm just going to move my syringe in 5 milliliter increments. Okay, so I'm going to stop data collection. So far I've recorded the data, but I haven't analyzed the data. But this is another strength of the SparkVue software. If I go to build a new page, I can look at pressure versus volume in a graph. So I have my data, and it looks like it's an inverse fit. But we want to test that. So I'm going to open up my tools. And I'm going to apply a fit to the entire data, and we'll do an inverse fit. And there we go. The data fits very nicely on that fit line. But we haven't explained why it fits nicely on that. And this is where the Odyssey software comes in. So this is the Odyssey software. This is the college chemistry version. There's also a high school version. In each version, there's a modeling kit, a stock room, applied chemistry, tutorials and demonstrations, and molecular labs. We're going to focus on the labs. When you open up the lab section, it's broken up into different chemistry concepts, from chemical matter down to biochemistry. We're going to look at gases and the pressure-volume relationship for gases, just like with the experiment we did with the PASCO equipment. The labs are broken up into objectives, procedures, and guided analysis questions. The instructors can print out Word documents, PDFs, and there are also answer keys available on the instructor's edition. This particular lab starts off with a 2D model and then builds up to a 3D model for the student experiment. That's the great thing about this software. It's not just an animation, it's a simulation. So the students will be able to build their own models and create their own parameters. So I'm just going to follow these instructions over here, and I'm going to build a sample of gas. So I'm going to pick nitrogen, and I'm going to put that sample of nitrogen, or a collection of those nitrogen molecules, into a container or a cell. And I'm going to change the view a little bit. I'm going to do a space-filling model so I can see this a little better. I'm also going to highlight the collisions with the molecules and the walls of the container. So now I have my sample set up, and now I want to do the experiment. This is where the analysis would come in. First, I'm going to create a graph of pressure and volume, just like I did with the PASCO lab. I'm going to make a new plot, an XY scatter plot of volume and pressure. We'll do a smooth fit. And we want to be able to change one of those parameters. The property that we want to change is the volume. So now I'm all set to do the experiment. And just like the PASCO lab, I'm going to start with a large volume and work my way down. I'm going to increase this volume. I'm going to change the view a little bit so that I can see the experiment a little better. Now this is the point where the students would be following along the procedure and answering the analysis questions. So I'm going to hit play. And I'm going to give this sample a little bit of time for the molecules to equilibrate into their new volume. After I give that a few seconds, then I will manually record the points, just like with the PASCO lab. So there's one data point. And we'll do a few data points to see if we can see the same trend on a molecular perspective that we saw on the macroscopic perspective. So shrinking the volume down, again letting it equilibrate. And we will record another point. And we'll do a couple more of these. And we'll record again. Now we're starting to see a change in the shape of that graph. A couple more points to round it out. Give it a few seconds. And we'll record. Looking very nice. And we'll do one more point. And again, the great thing about this is we're not just seeing the graph and the trend in the graph, we're also seeing the molecules and what's happening with them inside that container. So we're tying in those two levels of representation in chemistry. And there we go. So now we have a nice inverse relationship between pressure and volume, just like with the PASCO lab. And now we can understand why that's happening, or at least get a better understanding of why that's happening with this molecular perspective. So now you can see that the Odyssey software and the PASCO SPARKvue software complement each other very well. With PASCO's equipment, software, and analysis tools, we can understand chemistry from a macroscopic perspective. But to get a deeper understanding, we need a molecular perspective, and that's where the Odyssey software comes in. Thank you very much. This has been Tom Loschiavo. Feel free to reach me at chemistry@pasco.com.